was once a happy place, the Amazon rainforest teeming with life. Plants and animals going along at their own pace, and wildlife coexisting without any strife. But then came the Industrial Revolution, and that was when nature took a blow. Pollution spread everywhere without a solution, as humans went on with their show. The Amazon rainforest, once filled with trees, has now been destroyed out of adversity. With less oxygen produced to fulfill our pleas, habitat destruction, habitat fragmentation, and loss of biodiversity. Our grasslands, for farmlands we have chosen, have by our farming equipment to the ground shaven. No grass to hold the soil creates erosion, nitrates and phosphates creating cultural eutrophication. Pesticides, though with food as our assistant, we should look at them with disdain. DDT, very widely used, is very persistent. Bioaccumulates and biomagnifies in the food chain. The coral reefs, once from humans never reached, are now dying in an eye's blink. The coral becomes nothing but bleached as the ocean becomes the ultimate carbon sink. Coal, oil, and natural gas, things we take for granted. The effects thereof we should stand in mourning. Pollutants and greenhouse gases, burning them has chanted, as carbon dioxide contributes to global warming. With our machines, we have beaten down this poor earth. But us humans right now have a chance to learn. Either we turn around and give this abused planet a new rebirth, or we keep going to the point of no return.
War of attrition. What is love? It's the flutter in the chest when someone walks in the room. It's the pain felt when that person leaves, the strength ebbing away with each step. The smile that runs across lips when two people talk, the graze of two arms as they walk. It's the have a great day as a school bus rolls away, and the hugs and chatter shared at the end of the day. It's the rings on a pair of left hands, the promises, for better or for worse. What is war? It's the death of the flutter that began at the barrel of the gun. It's the pain of the bullets in his chest and their home. The smile that runs away when men in uniforms show up at the door. The graze of strange hands on black-clad shoulders in the face of a black backdrop future with a purple ribbon silhouette. It's the uncertain I'll see you later as the camo packs right away. And the silence of the dinner table at the end of the day. She wonders if the other half to their pair of left-hand rings is somewhere lying in the dust. The promise for worse coming to life as the blood mingles with the gold ring rust.
Hi, my name is Kennedy Wade, and I'll be presenting my poem, Home of the Free. America, home of the free, where it's free to get shot walking down the street, where it's free to get profiled because you're wearing a hijab, where little black girls go missing without any media coverage at all, where the woman makes 61 cents to every male dollar, where the entitled take all and leave nothing for the rest. Oh, what a place to be, America, home of the free.
Hi, I'm Brinda Rathina Sabapathy, a senior at Eastside High School. My poem is titled, Look Me in the Eye, Tell Me Everything's All Right. There is a fine line between innocence and ignorance. When an abundance of time passes, slipping to the bottom of the hourglass, one becomes the other. This war-torn, weary world is hopeless. Tragedy at every turn, and we tell ourselves, there is nothing we can do. We turn away, blind, like Lady Liberty, proud face pointed up at the sun, like Lady Justice, making judgments without looking anyone in the eyes. Not knowing is no excuse to not face people's pain. Look them in the eye and let love win. Compassion is a choice of consequence. Like a dove leaping from her perch, white wings splayed proudly against a clear blue sky, just trust in your ability to try. Love is not blind. Love is when the burden of knowledge has settled harsh and heavy on your shoulders, but there is still sunshine in your smile. Your radiance is enough. For if there is one thing that humanity excels at, it is finding a light in the darkness and never letting go.